Hey, are you a new player to Mordhau who's trying to get better at the game?
If you say so!
That's cool, I am too. And I've gone out of my way and tried to do you a solid as a new player, and I've gone and interviewed a bunch of high-level OCE players in Mordhau on what they think new players are doing wrong, and how they can improve. So, without further ado, sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. So, as you may have heard in my poorly put together intro for the video, this video is going to be a little bit different to our regular Road to Mastery videos, and this is mainly because during my journey to Mordhau Mastery, I've noticed many of my fellow noob peers that I started the game with growing angry with the sharp learning curve that Mordhau has and quitting Mordhau altogether. So I decided to make this instructional video with the help of some high-level OCE players to try and help some of you newer players who are struggling with the sharp learning curve in the game. The first player I decided to talk to was Imperialism, or Imp for short. Imp is a member of Team Exemplar, a highly competitive OCE team which has had great success in recent tournaments. Imp had this to say about newer players' swing manipulations and how to improve it.
So what a lot of new players, and even intermediate players, don't do right is they don't neutral their attacks. They will start dragging right away. And then it's just, yeah, there's no point doing that, because I can easily tell that you're going to drag your attack. So yeah, you would have to neutral your attack, which just means leaving it on your opponent for like a short amount of time, so that in the release window, that's when you drag it. So it's harder to tell if it's an excel or a drag. Overdragging is another thing. It's when you drag it too early and too far and it just phases through the person. So that means you just need to neutral it more. You can also fake excel, which is when you neutral, so look at them, and then you pretend to do an excel, and then you pull out. Those are like top tier types of swing manipulation. But some of the like insane stuff which top tier players do is late riposting, which is when you parry an attack after I think it's about 200 milliseconds. It extends your like attack. It's really weird. And also using wiggles. Wiggles is something that not many people know how to, but they're starting to become more popular. Yeah, those are just the main things that people should work on to master their swing manipulation.
In these following clips, I will then show you some examples of, first of all, a bad drag, and then a good drag. And what I mean by a bad drag is, like what Imp said, a drag that is not neutraled, and the professional term that is often used is telegraphed, and very easy to see coming. Followed by a good example of a drag, and one that will be using a fake excel as well. After interviewing Imperialism, I decided to interview Glad, the team leader of Kensei, who had some very good tips to talk about on footwork.
Mistake that I see most new players making is bad footwork or positioning. So what you'll typically see is new players will push in too close without attacking, and what that leads to is they'll essentially be kicked most of the time.
So footwork to make sure that they don't get kicked. So like, essentially, you're worrying about the spacing of the player,
making
sure they're keeping their opponent on the screen, kind of stuff.
Yes. So the main thing is that they will push in range of their opponent without actually having an attack ready. So and then they'll attack while they're already being threatened by their opponent. So and then you know. If their opponent is ready, they can just see them and that they're just not fast enough for their attack and just interrupt them with a kick. So what you need to do is you need to make sure that you are attacking like before you move into range of the opponent. And so that's one aspect. And another thing that they'll do a lot is they won't create distance after their opponent blocks them. So if you don't create distance after your opponent blocks you, your opponent can easily excel you in your face or drag you in face hug. So you have to move away from your opponent as fast as possible to give yourself more time to read, and it also prevents you from getting kicked.
Right.
And also what they'll typically not do is they won't kick themselves. So if the opponent is face hugging them, they need to use kicks to sort of establish their boundaries and prevent themselves from getting face hugged.
Next up, I decided to talk to Mano, who is also a high level OCE player, and he talked about crosshair placement, which is actually surprisingly very important for new players.
Yeah, so like, it's just like new players, they just need like keep their crosshair on the target, keep it still, keep calm. Just like, always try to keep your crosshair on them, like even if you turn around, whatever, like go back to them. And like, mainly just practice, like if you just play the game, you're gonna get better. But yeah, main thing is like, just keep your crosshair on them, keep calm.
Last but not least, we interviewed Cheeky from Team Exemplar on the issue of initiative.
One problem newer players tend to mistake is that they don't really understand the idea of initiative. Initiative is, to put it simply, when you should and when you shouldn't attack. This game is, if you boil it down, it's almost a turn, like a turn-based attack type of game. So the main attack is riposte. And now new players tend to, they attack the opponent and then the opponent ripostes. And then the person who inputted first, they input into the other person's riposte, but then parry out of it. The reason that this isn't good is because once you input, but then parry out of your input, you lose stamina. So new players tend to do this a lot and then they lose stamina very quickly, and that's the main reason that they lose their jewels. The reason, one of the things you can do to fix this is to recognize when your opponent does and doesn't riposte. If they do riposte, don't input. If they don't riposte, then you might be open to input to retake initiative. All right, I think that might be okay. Another form of when new players make this mistake is when they input and the opponent chambers and then the first person inputs again. But the reason you don't want to do this is because the opponent can just morph into a stab and then stab feint. And because stab feints aren't very easy to read, like 99% of the time, you're going to fall for that. So what you do if the opponent chambers is you don't input, or you chamber back, which contests initiative. So that forces the enemy to also read your attack, or they have to continue their attack. Okay. Another thing for a new player to recognize is that if they should try to recognize their opponent's patterns. Most people have certain patterns on their offense. If a player normally feints after they hit you and they're comboing, then you should take advantage of that and chamber the feint. Because you're likely get a free hit, or they have to parry out of their attack, giving you the initiative. So it's best to try and recognize their attacks, and then you can take advantage of when you know they're going to attack, and for you to chamber and retake initiative.
Thank you for coming by and watching the video. If you want to see the uncut versions of the interviews and the examples session, if you're a tier 1 sub on my channel, you'll be able to see those on my Discord server, which is new by the way, link in the description, same as my Twitch. And until then,
Gennaro stab.